Wow, look at this giant box that just showed up at my door. My wife and I had to haul it up the stairs. Let's see what's inside. Ah, now I see what I'm looking for. Ibanez. Yes, that's what I ordered. And wow, talk about packed well. The guitar box is actually packed in another box and with giant chunks of styrofoam packing all the way around. A really nice packing job. I hope we've got an Ibanez AS113 inside this box. I ordered it from Sweetwater. It took about 3 days to get here from Indiana, where their location is. And so let's get into this box and see what we got. Oh, it looks like nice packaging in the Ibanez box with plenty of bubble wrap around the hard shell case that comes with the AS113. Ah, there's the beauty. Ibanez AS113 with the brown sunburst. And the first thing I see is the inspection card signed off by Jeff C. And then here, this appears to be the 55 items that they checked. Quite nice. All right. Well, it looks like we've got a very nice case. I really like the headstock on these Ibanez guitars. Very nice. It also has some very nice binding. And one of the other things that was different on this model is besides having a bone nut, is I've got binding on the F holes. And I didn't see that on too many other models. It's only reserved for the really expensive ones. And I've got my two volume controls and two tone controls, and then their humbucker pickups. All right, let's get this sweet guitar out of the case and see what she can do. And here we have a front view of the brown sunburst design. And there we have a back view. Very nice looking guitar. Now these are the standard things I believe that come with the guitar. We'd already talked about the 55 point inspection, and serial number is indicated. Jeff C. All the stuff is good when they're checking the intonation and all the cosmetic issues. The frets, are they nice and smooth? And all looks good. Then you have the Ibanez has got a 1 year warranty, but Sweetwater does add another 2 years of warranty, and I'm not sure if that's concurrent with this, meaning it's an extra year, or if it's this warranty plus two from Sweetwater. I've got keys for the case. I got the truss rod Allen wrench. I got a it looks like an owner's manual that's for guitars and basses, and I guess this is just a little Sweetwater brochure. Yeah. So all in all, the AS113 and the letters are BS on it, which stands for brown sunburst, as opposed to you know what. But I certainly, the reason I bought it is I like the ebony fretboard. I liked it was really lightweight. It comes in 7.8 pounds. I played my cousin's old 335 Gibson, and man, it was heavy. And I thought, I don't know if I even want one of these. And obviously, this is a lot less expensive. This comes in right at $1,000, and the case is included. And so this is a pretty nice buy for the quality. It's got the bone nut on it, which is an upgrade from the AS93, which I looked at first. That is $700, but it doesn't have a case, and it doesn't have the ebony fretboard. Doesn't have the bone nut, and I wasn't sure about the binding. But one of the reasons that I also bought it is because the bindings, even in the F holes, it's really really nice binding. It's as nice as I had a Gibson. Let's see. Trying to remember what the number was, but it was a semi-hollow. It was really heavy, which I didn't like, And that binding was great, but that's a $3,000 guitar. This is only a $1,000 guitar. And I love free shipping, right? When you, I mean, even if you're buying something on the internet, there's plenty of places, and even used guitars too, where you can pay $50. Some guys are even asking $150 for shipping. So free shipping was nice. And this has got an extra switch for the pickups. There's two switches. One of them's a standard one where, you can choose the bridge pickup or the neck pickup, or both together. And then you have something there, Ibanez calls tri-sound, where in one position it's the two pickups are in series, one position they're in parallel, and then one acts as a single coil. So you got some additional options there.
Yeah, I've got a Boss Blues Driver and a Vox Wah-Wah kind of set up here today. And I'll be playing through my Vox AC15 tube amp today. Obviously, that's with the blues driver on. Okay, we'll take the blues driver off. And how about this wah-wah pedal? Mama said, let's play that guitar. Well, the first feel for it is it's got a kind of a smooth feel. I like the ebony fretboard. The binding is nice. It's not very smooth along the frets. That part's nice. The weight feels good. It feels good in my lap. And I just have to figure out what combination of these switches work, right? So I'm not even sure which one is which, but one of them's controlling down here on the bridge pickup. This one's the neck pickup. And then in the center, I'm guessing is both of them together. And this other one's that combination one. So that's an additional item that you pick up with this model. Now this model, as far as I know, was not made in Japan. This one's made in Indonesia. The next one up, which I think is that 2200, and maybe I'm not, maybe I don't have that exactly positive that there's nothing in between, but then you jump up to about 2500. So big jump in cost to go from $1,000 here up to $2,200, and this really feels good. Everything on it looks and feels as good as the last Gibson I had. I think it was an ES-137. Maybe I don't have that right. I sold it quite a while ago. I didn't like it because it was heavy, and it was just too big. And this one here really has a much better feel. I think it was thicker. This is a little bit thinner, and maybe this is what they call a slim line. And I think that Gibson was more of a standard, a thicker one. So I like that part about it. Nice sounding guitar. I'm pleased for the amount of money that I spent on this. And Mama said it was okay, so guess what? It came, and I got it. Well, I hope you got something out of this. This is a nice little change for kind of a mid-price guitar, and I think I made a good decision. Got great looks. The tuners feel, you know, that they're smooth. And like I said, the neck. This is. I don't feel anything. I can see all these frets are rounded off in comparison to some of my other guitars, you know, where they have an edge, it's not sharp. But these things are nice and rounded. And it's, you know, it seems like it's set up as well as it could be. I don't know what I would need to, as far as setup goes. It feels good. I just had to do a little bit of tuning and ready to go. So, good guitar, and I hope we got something out of this. Take it easy, and we'll see you next time. Thank you.